Hello all. So my name is Zohir Chaudhry, and now we will focus on why it is important to study environmental health. So why environmental health? Why is ensuring a healthy environment is important? Food, water, sanitation, air pollution, climate change critically affect a population's health. Environmental health issues such as climate change, indoor and outdoor air pollution, water pollution, food safety, and hygiene are major risk factors in the global burden of disease. Children, elderly, pregnant women, and immunocompromised people are at higher risk of health problems related to environmental pollution. And we can see from this infographic from the World Health Organization of the WHO, which shows that environmental pollutants can cause health problems such as stroke, respiratory diseases, heart diseases, waterborne diseases, and many other types of cancers. So reducing environmental risk factors can prevent many serious health problems and deaths. Globally, one in four of all deaths are estimated to be attributable to the environment. In total, the number of deaths linked to environment amounts to approximately 12.6 million per year. This burden could be lessened significantly by reducing risks through changes to the modifiable environment. Assuming this chart, the impact of the environment on health is unevenly distributed across major disease groups. The largest number of deaths attributed to the environment, about 8.2 million deaths per year, is now caused by non-communicable diseases. And the remaining 2.5 million deaths per year is from infectious and the other 2 million deaths per year are from injuries. Injuries such as motor vehicle related injuries, falls, drowning are often largely conditioned directly by the environment. On the left side, we can see this bar graph. The graph lists each disease, and the pink colored portion shows the percentage attributable to environmental causes. The diseases with the main environmental contribution are the cardiovascular diseases, followed by diarrheal diseases and respiratory infections and cancers. In this chart, we can actually see what possible environmental actions we can engage in to prevent some of these diseases. And you can see on the bottom in here, the specific course of action that can be employed in preventing each of these disease categories in here. It is worth paying attention to each of these preventive actions. One Health is an approach that recognizes that the health of people is closely connected to the health of animals and our shared environment. One Health is not new, but it has become more important in recent years. This is because many factors have changed the interaction among people, animals, plants, and our environment. Here, this infographic from WHO again lists some of the specific environmental factors that affect human health, such as air pollution, inadequate water and sanitation, the use of chemical, use of radiation, the noise level in the community, as well as occupational risk that arises from various work practices, agricultural practices, the built environment, as well as from the greater climate as in general. Now I'm going to show you a few photos or images from different countries around the globe to just provide you a glimpse of how environment is related to the well-being of people. So the figure on your left shows a coal-fired power station contributing to ambient air pollution, which affects millions and millions of people around the globe, especially in China and India, where pollution levels are very, very bad. On your right, you can see a woman cooking using open fire stove inside her home and the pollution associated with its usage. Many countries around the globe still rely on solid fuels for cooking and heating, and that women and children are exposed to those levels, to these high levels of pollution. In this slide, the figure on the left is from Jakarta, Indonesia. This figure shows clogged up open sewers, poor drainage, and lack of solid waste management, and how this creates urban conditions around the world conducive to intense transmission of communicable diseases. The figure on your right shows a man mixing pesticides for agricultural application, removing the most toxic pesticides from agricultural practice and reducing access to pesticides would prevent many suicides around the globe. In this image from Niger, Africa, children are playing in this flooded street. Children are particularly vulnerable to schistosomiasis, which is a waterborne disease related to lack of sanitation, poor hygiene practice, and recreational water use. The figure to your right is from Uruguay in South America. Household water storage requires safeguards such as covers or protective netting to prevent the breeding of mosquito vectors, which carry a wide array of diseases such as malaria, Zika, dengue, to name a few. The figure to your left is from Morocco, Africa. It shows a worker washing leather before it is dyed. Many chemicals used in the leather tanning industry have been linked to various forms of cancer. The figure to your right is from Havana, Cuba. You can see a health worker checking used tires for the breeding of Aedes mosquito, which is a vector for dengue, chikungunya, and Zika virus. Occupational environments pose a lot of risk to workers. On the left, you can see a worker in Cambodia grinding metals without ear protection. And on your right, you can see a man using a ladder. Falls in the workplace and at home can be reduced by safeguards and other fittings. You can see more work-related health risks illustrated in these two images. Protective clothing and equipment are important in reducing workplace injuries. On the left side, you can see in here workers wearing full body cover, boots and gloves, and protect and reflective clothing. On the right side, you can see workers wearing masks and gloves to protect against dust particles in a cement factory. So I hope that you've been able to understand the deep connection of the environment and human health. So the rainbow model of determinants of health incorporates some of these aspects in here. So in this model, you can see at its core the individual biological determinants such as age, sex, and constitutional characteristics. These characteristics affect health and are largely fixed. From here, the framework adds layers of determinants that are socially determined from individual lifestyle factors. And further upstreams are those factors and services that impact on health at the population level that are theoretically modifiable by policies. You can see how many factors are tied to the environment we live in, the quality of our house, the quality of our work environment, including living and working conditions, the air that we breathe and the water that we drink or we bathe in, as well as the food that we consume, all have influence to our health and well-being. So I hope that you've been able to understand the connection between human health and the environment and why it is important to study environmental health so that we can take proper preventive actions to improve our health and well-being. Thank you for listening, and please do not forget to subscribe to this channel. Thank you.